Floyd Landis made the confession to ESPN.com and the Wall Street Journal. He had been denying doping allegations since winning and then being stripped of the 2006 Tour de France title. When Landis visited the Susquehanna Valley in 2007, he sat down with News 8's Ann Shannon, who asked him whether he was innocent.
And you're absolutely innocent.
Absolutely.
Tonight, Landis's confession has a lot of people talking. News 8's Barbara Barr talked with people in his hometown of Farmersville. She joins us live from there with more tonight. Good evening, Barbara.
Good evening, Ron. The Floyd Landis story has been a roller coaster ride for family and friends. First, they cheered as he won the Tour de France. Then they defended him against the doping allegations. And now they're just disappointed that he lied. A sign outside Paul and Arlene Landis's home in Farmersville, Lancaster County reads, "Sorry, no press." Others study John 8. He without sin cast a stone. Floyd Landis now admits to using performance-enhancing drugs during his cycling career and says the toughest phone call he ever made was to his mother, telling her the truth.
I came to talk to her and because I know that she's, you know, suffering. So I just wanted to give her my support.
Landis came clean because, quote, "I want to clear my conscience. I don't want to be part of the problem anymore." Neighbors are reacting to his revelation.
I guess he's trying to clear his conscience. I don't know what else it could be. I just figure you should just stand up and be honest from the beginning.
Landis was stripped of the 2006 Tour de France title after testing positive for a banned substance. Initially, he fought the charges, and supporters back home donated money to his legal defense fund.
I think that he should be a man and give back to our community.
Landis claims other cyclists, including seven-time Tour de France winner Lance Armstrong, also cheated. A cyclist and friend of the Landis family puts a positive spin on the situation.
Can't say I was that surprised. I think it's pretty prevalent in the sport, and him coming clean is going to help a lot of other people end up admitting and kind of making the sport better all around.
So why is Landis coming forward now? Well, he says the statute of limitations for doping offenses is 8 years and is about to run out on information he knows about other cyclists. We're live here in Lancaster County. I'll send it back to you, Ron.
All right. Thank you, Barbara.